Hi, Alex here from Rebelloper.com, and welcome back to the Christmas calendar tutorial series. And today we are on the episode 2 of our Tiny Constraints hands-on examples. So without further ado, let's get started. Great. Now, we have left off by creating all of this awesome UI. And let me just bring up the example that we are going to create. There we go. Let me just make this like so. Great. And it looks pretty similar. And we are using, again, Tiny Constraints. If you are new to this video, go ahead and take a look at the previous one on the playlist. We have added our Tiny Constraints pod, and we have added our UI here. And I can see that this subscribers is a little bit too large, so I will start tweaking on that and maybe add this cog a little bit lower. So let's start with that. So the channel subscribers, let's say 14, and let's tweak our channel subscribers offset should be, let's say, 3, and the cog, the top, let's say 16. Let's build and run again. Okay, next up, what we want to add is a container for, and it looks pretty wet, a container for our videos. So let's go all the way up and let's add a let videos container view, and it will be a simple UI view, and let's add that in here. Okay, and let's initialize it. Let view equals UI view, and let's hit return here, and let's set the view's background color, and let's open up our Xcode, our Photoshop here, and let's select this color here, and it's 404040. Okay, pretty easy to remember. Great, let's go back to Xcode and equals to UI color, and let's use again the red, green, and blue. So 40 divided by 255, 440 divided by 255, and the alpha value should be 1.0. Okay, now let's constrain this video's container view. What is wrong with this? Let UI view, let's hit build. Oh, we need to return the view. Okay, let's go all the way down to our container view. Should have this video's container view. Video's container view, pretty straightforward. Okay, now let's anchor our video's container view. Video's container view, top anchor, and we should add the top anchor to our bottom of our channel subscribers count label. So, channel subscribers count label, and the offset, let's set it to 8 for now, and let's delete all of the rest. Okay, again, in the video's container view, left 2 and container view, video's container view, right 2, container view, and again with the bottom, video's container view, bottom 2, container view. Okay, let's build and run and see if we do have that other type of black there, that container view. And indeed, I don't know if you can realize it or not, it's here. And let me just take a look at the padding here. It should be a bit larger. So let's add in here, let's say 24. Let's build and run again. Now, next, we want to add our, let's say, featured video. Yeah, it looks really nice. Let's take a look at the image that we are going to build out. So we are going to add this featured video. Okay, and it will be a simple UI image view. Of course, it needs to be either a button or you could add a UI gesture, tap gesture recognizer to that image view if you want to make this tappable. So for now, let us just add this UI image view. Okay, let's go ahead and create our, I will name this, and it will be of UI image view. What else? We need to set this image view to be, let's say, the content mode. Okay, and let's add in here our image, and let's add an image literal, and double click on it and select this one. Okay, and I believe that should cover it all. Now we want to add this to our videos container view, so add subview and let's say featured video image view. Great. Now let's constrain it. Let's just scroll all the way down. And what we want to achieve is basically, let's type in featured image view and let's say edges two, and here we go. And the constrainable is the videos container view. Videos container view, excluding the bottom, and the insets should be at the top, let's say dot top, and let's add in here 8 for now. Let's add this to our left to 8, and let's add the right one to right and 8. Okay, priority and is active can be omitted. Okay, and next up, let's have our image, or rather, let's just build and run and see if we do get an image there. Maybe we need to set the height of our image. Yes, we need to do that. So let me just go here and featured image view height on, let's say 300, and I will create a constant for it in just a moment, but for now let us just see how this works. Okay, and I can see that the insets are not set up correctly. Let's see, here should be 16 and let's say minus 16, I believe. Let's see how that works. And the left should be 16. And 300 is a little bit too much, so let's say 250. Let's build and run again. See what we got. Okay, we are almost there. Maybe let's add in here 200. And then we will take a look at the insets. There we go. The insets are quite right, and I believe they are okay indeed. Great. Okay, that will cover it all. Now what I want to add next up is this label for our timestamp. Okay, and not the timestamp, the duration. So let's add a new label here. And I will simply set the background color, the label's background color, to be UI color. And let's set this to be red, green, and blue. And I believe we need to have this 0 divided by 255. 0 divided by 255. Again, 0 to 255. The alpha value should be 0.7. Okay, and let's add our labels text to be, let me see the duration, 1317. Okay, 1317, and maybe set the labels text color to be white. Okay, let's build and run and see what this actually does. Oh, rather yet, we still need to anchor it. So let's stop that and anchor it to our featured video image views, bottom right corner. Okay, so what we need to do here is type in duration label. And first of all, we are going to set the bottom two, and I will choose this one, bottom two, and the constrainable will be our featured video image view. And let's set the anchor. And I believe we need to set this to -0. And let me just delete all of this. Okay, now let's set the duration labels right to, yes, to our featured image view. And again, the offset should be, I believe, -0. Let's delete all of these. And now we should basically set up a width and a height. So duration label dot width, let's say the width, let's start off with 50, and duration label dot height, let's say 30. Let's see how that looks like. And did we add it to our views? No. So featured video image view, add subview and duration label. Let's build and run. There we go. It looks fairly nice. What I would like to have is to set the width of this to be, let's say, 40. Let's take a look at that again. Yes. And on the label, I would like to change the font. So label.font equals UI font. And bold system font of size, let's say 14. And I would like to still set the text alignment to be dot center. Okay, let's see how that looks, and it should look awesome. Great, I really like it. Next up, you could add the profile image view for this video and the labels and so on. Let me just bring up the finder here. Here we go, the simulator. So we can add all of these, but we have talked about this in the previous video, and it is fairly simple to do. Okay, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial series about tiny constraints. Go ahead, check out the GitHub repository. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.